Welcome to Learn It. In this previous section, we had already completed some of the topics of the chapter Reproduction in Organism, and we had taken topic 1. So let us have a small recap, in which we have studied lifespan for different organisms, like different kinds of organisms, mayfly, butterfly, dogs, monkey, etc. We had also learned about the lifespan, what is reproduction, why it is important, types of reproduction, which is asexual and sexual. Types of asexual reproduction we have already taken in details. We have divided into 2 parts, one is animal and one is plant. In plants, we have already divided into fissions, budding, sporulation and fragmentation. And in plants, it is called vegetative propagation. We have already studied different kinds of asexual reproduction with the help of fission also. And fission is again divided into binary and multiple. Sporulations, budding, which is divided into external budding and internal budding, fragmentations, and type of asexual reproduction in plant, which is also known as vegetative propagations. And we have divided vegetative propagation in 2 topics, which is natural vegetative propagation and artificial vegetative propagations. So that was the end of the topic 1 revision. Now let us move to the next topic, which is biology, chapter 1. Reproduction in Organism, topic 2. In this topic, we'll be talking about only sexual type of reproduction, which will include some of the points like what are the phases of sexual reproduction, what are the types of sexual reproduction in plants and animals, and in the next video, we'll be talking about the last topic of this chapter, which will be pre, during, and post fertilization. So let us begin with the first topic, which is sexual reproduction. It basically involves the formation of male and female gametes by 2 different individuals of the opposite sex, which means one should be a male and second should be a female. It is compulsory to have 2 kinds of opposite sex. Second is offspring which is produced by these kind of fusions. One is of male and one is of female are not identical to each other. But in part of asexual reproduction, the offspring produced are always of the same, which is why they are called as clones. The third point says that all sexual reproducing organism shares a similar pattern of reproductions. In sexual reproduction, fusion of male and female gametes result in offspring that are not identical to parents. So what are the advantages of such kind of sexual reproductions? It helps in the genetic recombination in offspring, which can cause variations in genes and ultimately resulting in variation in offsprings. And second is, it plays a very important role in the evolution of a new species or a new organism. These kind of fusion will help in the formation of ultimately a zygote, which is the byproduct of sexual reproduction whenever it involves the fusion of male and female gametes. As we move forward, next topic, we'll encounter one thing, which is what are the different phases in sexual reproduction. So starting from the birth to the death, there are basically 3 steps which has to complete for going on for the sexual reproduction. The first is the juvenile phase. Now what do you mean by juvenile phases? It is the period between birth and sexual maturity. It is just a period between when an organism has a birth or attains its sexual maturity is called a juvenile phase. In this, if a plant is grown, it is called a vegetative phase, and in animals it is called as juvenile phase. The end of juvenile, or we call vegetative in plants, this phase marks the beginning of reproductive phase in animals and plants. The second phase in sexual reproduction is basically reproductive phase. It comes after vegetative, or we can say that juvenile phase. In some plant shows flowering in particular season and some other flower in all season. Some other plants like bamboo species flowers once in a lifetime, that is after 50 to 100 years. Strombilanthus kunthania, which is also known as Nilkoranji, flowers once in 12 years. In plants, basically they are divided into annual and biennial plants on the basis of different vegetative and reproductive and senescent phases. In animals, if the female placental animals exhibit cyclic changes in activities, ovaries and accessory glands as well as hormone during the reproductive phase, they are divided into two kinds. One is known as menstrual cycle and second one is known as oestrus cycle. So let us discuss about the first topic, which is menstrual cycle. Now these kind of cycles occur in monkey, apes and human beings. It is basically a three-phase cycle in which the first phase is menstrual, the second one is called proliferative phase and the third one is known as secretory phase. What happens in this is the blood flows in the last few days of the cycle which broke endometrium, and this endometrium is passed out during the menstruation. The female does not permit copulation during menstrual phase of the cycle in case of many organisms. Let us move to the new topic, which is oestrus cycle, and what happens in oestrus cycle and in which kind of organism these kind of cycles occurs. It basically occurs in non-primates, a very old kind which have not changed from many years, like cow, sheep, rat, deer, dog, tiger, etc. It basically consists of a short period of oestrus, or which is called as heat. It is 12 to 24 hours in cow, followed by anoestrus or passive period. In this, blood does not flow in this cycle. The broken endometrium wall is again reabsorbed inside the body. The female permits copulation during these kind of oestrus period. In both plants and animals, hormones are only responsible for the transition between different phases of life cycle. Interacting between hormones and environmental factor regulates the reproductive process in these kind of organisms. The next topic brings us to the senescent phase. Now what do you mean by senescent phase? Let us start with this. It is the end of reproductive phase, which is marked by the onset of another phase, which is the starting of another phase called as senescent phase, which is also known as old age. It is basically the end of reproductive phase, which ultimately leads to the death. Now when we are talking about the sexuality in the plants, the sexuality depends on two things. The plants have been categorized in two things. One is known as homothelic, which is also known as monoecious plant, and the second one is known as heterothelic or dioecious plant. In homothelic or monoecious plant, the male and female reproductive structures may be present on the same plant. For example, in chara, coconut palm and cucurbita. The second point is the heterothelic or dioecious plant. Now what is the basic difference is that the male and female reproductive parts may be present on different plant. For example, Markensia and date palm. In case of sexuality in plants, when it is regarding to the flowers, it is categorized into two parts. One is bisexual flowers and the second one is known as unisexual flowers. The bisexual flowers, in which flower contains both stamen and pistil. Now let me clear you. The sexual reproductive part of male is in plants is called as a stamen, and the sexual reproductive part of a female is called pistil. If a flower contains both stamen and pistils, it is called bisexual flowers, or a flower having both stamen and pistil. For example, China rose and pea. The second is unisexual flowers. If a flower contains either a stamen or a pistil, if it is having a male reproductive organ or a female reproductive organ, which is stamen or pistil, we'll call it unisexual flower. For example, papaya, watermelon, sunflower, wheat, rice, etc. comes under unisexual flowers. As we have already studied about the two things in animals, which is basically menstrual cycle and oestrus cycle, We'll again go to one thing which is known as, they are also sexual reproduction in plants, which are categorized into two things. One is continuous breeders and the second one is known as sexual or seasonal breeders. In continuous breeders, reproductively active, these kind of continuous breeders are reproductively active throughout their reproductive phase. Like in humans, they can breed at any time. But in seasonal breeders, they are reproductively active only during some of the favorable conditions in their reproductive phase. For an example, there are dogs, birds, frogs, etc. The sexuality in animals also depends on the two things, which is bisexual and unisexual. Sexuality also has been divided into two categories. The one is bisexual and the second one is the unisexual. What happens in the bisexual is they possess both male and female reproductive organs in the same individual. In a same individual, both the categories will be there. Like in male reproductive and female reproductive organ, both the organs will be present. Such kind of organism is called as bisexual animal. Let us take an example, which is earthworm, tapeworm, leech, etc. But when we are talking about unisexual, in this both the sexes are separate with distinct male and female individual, which means male will have male reproductive part and the female will have the female reproductive part. For example, cockroach, dogs, etc. comes under unisexual animals. That's it for today's video. I hope you have understood the topics very well. But for more understanding, I urge all of you to repeat this video again for clearer understanding. If you like the video and its content, give it a thumbs up and don't forget to comment your name in the comment section. If you are unable to understand or is struggling in any of the topic, please write the topic in the comment section. I'll surely try to get to you soon. So for more of such videos, stay tuned to the channel. Stay safe, stay healthy, and don't forget to learn it.